We are about to jump into qualifying. And hopefully this weekend's a little bit different than the first. Just a wee bit different.
Okay, I know you're eager to get out there, but I'm going to need you to be patient for a few minutes. We're just trying to zero in on an oil leak.
Lubrication fault. Put me on the back foot. Get out there. I'm kind of surprised I haven't patched qualifying mode out of the qualification rooms. Or even fuel mix entirely. It's close.
Best lap so far is a 1:24.0.
We are a second clear, so we could one stop. We probably still can one stop even on the Well, let's see what we get. It looks like we will be able to climb this in. And we're third. That is a good time. DeVries is doing the same thing. And Bottas did go under the soft. He did not feel safe. It's supposed to be a 1 second delta, but we actually only lost 6 tenths. Maybe 7. It's actually because the wear on the softs is that bad. Yeah, we're gonna save one set of them. I might wish I'd saved two. Alright, we're a little bit slow.
So far, our fastest lap is a 1:23.6.
Gotta get back out there and try to get pole. Oh wow, I need like 3 tenths. Can I find that kind of time?
And with qualifying complete, let's review our top
he improved
today.
More.
De Vries, Williams, and Valtteri Bottas. Well, that wraps up qualifying, but don't worry, we'll be back tomorrow as we head into the Grand Prix.
Okay.
Great workout there today. Let's have your thoughts. Great qualifying session. Are you feeling safer ahead of the pack? Your teammate beat you today. Was it a setup issue or something else? Great. Well, that's everything.
Well, we're just stuck here on a very, very long loading screen.
All right. I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
29. So we have about 60. Yeah. Not sure what the ideal strategy will actually be. Our tire wear rate's really good. We'll have a bit of an advantage over De Vries on that. If we can get by him and maybe pull out a gap, then, you know, everything becomes possible.
The stage is set for another enthralling race here in the Kingdom of Bahrain. A Ferrari stronghold in years gone by, but will they be able to add to their record today? There's no shortage of passing opportunities around the 3.36 miles of the Bahrain International Circuit, with the best at turn one, of course, and then another soon into turn four. 15 corners here, 6 to the left and 9 to the right, and we could see one or two flat spots into the tight left-hander of turn 10. Joining us today to oversee all the thrills and spills, it's Anthony Davidson. Ant, great to see you. How are you feeling about the race today, and how are the circuit conditions from what you've seen?
Well, it's looking a bit cold out there, if I'm honest. These tyres have quite a narrow operating window in terms of the temperatures they need to extract the best grip. So with a cold track surface, it's going to be harder to keep those temperatures up, which will lead to lower grip and maybe more mistakes.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Nick de Vries lines up on pole position, and Williams completes the front row. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Bottas, Verstappen, Lewis Hamilton, and Leclerc, Ricciardo, Albon, Gasly, and Daniel Kvyat, Stroll, Ocon, George Russell, and Perez, Sainz, Magnussen, Antonio Giovinazzi, and Lando Norris, Grosjean, Latifi, Matsushita, and Giuliano Alesi. Now, it's almost time for lights out, so let's go down to the track.
All right, we are just about ready to roll.
Now that we've got some points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish.
Okay. That looks fine. We'll flex it around based on the actual.
Right, let's get the car up to temperature on this lap. We're learning the gears, so go through them all if you can. Expected. No rain expected for the time being.
Alright, we're going to the line. The window for a two-stop is lap 10.
The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. out position on lap one. That's not great, but it's not terrible. Stay focused.
There is a little bit of that initial surge.
Nick is ahead of you. Our gap to the car in front is 1.1 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. Their tyres are one lap old. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1 minute 29.9. Use your overtake button more. It's time to utilize some of this energy.
Set medium.
We don't currently have the data for that request. Some information on Stroll, they're retiring from the race. VSC deployed, the virtual safety car has been deployed. We need to keep a positive delta here. Slow down, maintain a positive delta.
Stroll. I think that's an engine. That's a mechanical failure.
Okay, slow down, slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. VSC ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags.
We're pulling her in.
Was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up.
DRSing teammates is probably one of the most difficult things you're ever going to do. The air is just so dirty. Yeah, I don't think we're gonna win this by playing it safe on pit strategy.
Let's use overtake and burn some of this energy.
Shoot.
Expect the grip levels to start falling away soon. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the mediums. Understood, stopping this lap.
Softer tires will enable me to pit and overtake a little bit quicker.
Complete, go now. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track.
We're slot gapping.
work. That's a new fastest lap of the race.
I think if anything is going to be faster, it's going to be soft versus hard.
Nick is coming in for a stop. Strategy is available on the MFD. Okay, copy that.
I'm just focusing here, so I know I'm not saying much. I apologize.
We've got a lot of spare energy. Use your overtake button. approaching the pit window, you'll be on the mediums. We're leading our teammate by 4.2 seconds.
We can't really pull away much more.
Tire condition is still looking good. We're gonna box this lap, push hard on the in lap.
Tires are pretty much in equilibrium now. Goes DeVries. Yeah, the medium tire is going to be a better sustained.
Go, go, go. Up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those tires.
Thank you. Okay, let's see if we can pull in.
Good job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. Nick ahead. The gap to the car ahead is 14.3 seconds. They're on old hards. Their tyres are 7 laps old. The time last lap was a 1:28.0. Battery charge is high. Let's use that overtake button more. Nick is ahead of you. Gap to car in front is 12.9 seconds. They're on old hards. Their tyres are 8 laps old. The time last lap was a 1 minute 27.7. You're closing in by around 1.4 seconds a lap.
Gonna be close.
The gap to the next car is currently 12 seconds. The car behind is dropping back. We're seeing a gap form. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining.
Our lap times are skyrocketing. I think we just picked the wrong strategy. I cannot make up the pit stop time.
Nick ahead. Okay, gap ahead is 11.5 seconds. They're on old hards. Their tyres are 11 laps old. The time last lap was a 1:27.5. You're gaining by 1/10 a lap.
Yeah, we're fastest. Two-stop strategies just don't work anymore, unfortunately. I need to be doing better, though, if I want to win the Drivers' Championship again.
There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. Increasing our gap on the car behind by around a second a lap.
The lap times are flat, which you wouldn't expect running against a slower compound.
Some information on Giovinazzi. They are out of the race. Yellow flag. Someone's come off ahead of you. There's a yellow flag ahead. Green flag. There's only 1 lap of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race.
is actually gaining now. That's
job.
Fun.
You did really well. Super driving.
It wasn't always plain sailing today, but a very important win nonetheless. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
I think that smart tyre management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
Okay.
The faces on our top three look so incredibly happy as they make their way up to the podium. A much-deserved victory and a brilliant performance from them all. Let's see what effect this result has had on the driver's standings. It's a great result for Nick.
So yeah, we're 14 points behind.
At the top of the table. So,
we have a problem, and that problem is that our teammate is too quick.
Well, you can't fault anything that Sergio Perez did out on the track today. He drove flawlessly, making him an easy pick.
It's time to check out the constructor's standings. The current leaders continue to extend their lead at the top. Meanwhile, a strong weekend from Red Bull this time out, and they improve their position in the championship. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
Looks like we did just manage to sneak a point away by doing that two-stop strategy. But we had a real chance of winning too, so that's not particularly great anyway. We probably should have won.
The fans really seem to enjoy that. You made it look easy. How good does it feel to have both cars in your team take the top spots? You must be thrilled to be up on the podium. How do you feel after your teammate's victory? Are you happy for them, or do you wish it were you?
Wish it were me, but I'm still happy for them.
Your teammate is up on the podium today. This is a great thing for the team, isn't it? Great. Well, that's everything.
Yeah, I think we gotta do one stoppers. Yeah, the money's rolling in, so that part's fine. 4K in damage deductions, whatever. Got some resources. We'll renew the sponsor. So I can do up to 3. Okay. Yeah, we're just gonna really start cranking away on these durability upgrades. And we will go to Vietnam and then China. If I can get my car in front, we can start reversing the driver's championship stats. But if not, if I'm not fast enough, then you know we'll just do our part. And I'm helping DeVries win the championship. Or help our team win the constructors. I mean, I'm going to try to challenge him, but he's getting quite difficult to challenge. Okay, that'll do it for today. Still got a ton of R&D going on. Probably shore up the chassis while we wait for our durability upgrades to roll in. But yeah. Thank you for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed. If you haven't already done so, feel free to follow button above one time. Or sub, like, and share if you're catching on YouTube. Till next time, have a great one. We'll see you again next time. Till then, later on, guys.